on and just goes on. Time to make the club go up. Time to shut the club down. This is not how I woke up, but it's how I look now. If you leave with me, we'll be on till morn. Then we rinse and repeat, and it just goes on. Time to make the club go up. Time to shut the club down. This is not how I woke up, but it's how I look now. If you leave with me, we'll be on till morn. Then we rinse and repeat, and it just goes on. Time to make the club go up. Time to shut the club down. This is not how I woke up, but it's how I look now. If you leave with me, we'll be on till morn. Then we rinse and repeat, and it just goes on.
I messed up tonight. I lost another fight. I still mess up, but I just start again. I keep falling down.
Accelerator, and for this year we've changed it up quite a bit. For 2017, we brought in corporate partners to help sponsor the program and be a part of the program on a day-to-day basis. Our sponsors this year are, of course, Sprint and the brands underneath them, which include Pinsight Media and Virgin Mobile. And this year we've also brought in the Dairy Farmers of America.
The Sprint Accelerator itself, really obviously a top-tier accelerator, and I think one of the cool things about the way the program's been done this year is there's real partnership in it. I think there's this cookie cutter nature to quite a lot of accelerators that currently exist, whereby you get your money, you come in, you're out, and then you're shopped out, right? So I think one of the really cool things, which I think speaks to Sprint's presence here in Kansas City as well, is that sense of community and closeness to the companies that are actually part of the accelerator.
We were blown away. Day one, we walked into a meeting with DFA, and those guys basically proactively came up with, you know, a list of 17 use cases for us. We were expecting by the middle or end of the program, both parties get to know each other well enough to then figure out what's next. But these guys, you know, came to bat from day one.
Before the program, we were already working with Sprint. Through the program, two additional relationships. So one, Sprint as a advertiser, so on the customer side. And then third, the subsidiary Pinsight Data, helping us with telco data, et cetera, as well as attribution back in terms of how effective was the media.
The great thing is all seven companies are growing due to the partnerships that we've created with our corporate sponsors. And at the end of the program, they're going to actually be doing business together. And that was a key goal for 2017.
As a fairly young startup and our pivot from focusing on small business to larger enterprise customers, working with a company like DFA at this such an intimate level, you know, is worth its weight in gold.
And we have already started to work with Pinsight and Sprint on various different capacities that we just didn't even imagine before coming into this program. So that's been extremely valuable for us.
Having advisors come in that can help us think about that or connect us with people that can help us in those areas, that's huge. So, and just that, just being able to connect and create those networks of people that are knowledgeable or that can help, that's really, really important to us.
The Sprint DFA program has been so amazing. We've had the opportunity to work closely with the folks from DFA, to work with mentors from within the industry and from within Kansas City. The focus that Kansas City has on the animal health corridor has been significant for us to bring together potential resources and partners to be able to work with her dog and really move our business forward much faster. So if you think about Accelerator in this purest sense of the word, that's really what's happening here.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Managing Director of the Sprint Accelerator, Doug Dressler.
Good morning. Good morning. That wasn't bad. Thank you so much for being here. Welcome to the Sprint Accelerator 2017 Demo Day. We're excited that you're here, and we're very excited to show you what we've been working on over the last 3 months. This morning, you're going to hear words like neuroscience and hyperlocal and cow. No, seriously, you're going to see a lot of cows, and it's awesome. As you saw in the video, we changed it up a little bit for our fourth year, and we brought in a new corporate partner, the Dairy Farmers of America. More on that in a minute. But first, we can't do this without support. Support from people like you, from our community, from our great corporate sponsors. And, of course, our new community partner, the Kauffman Foundation. Now, our relationship with the Kauffman Foundation is not new. We've been involved with them since this was all just in the idea stage. But this year, our relationship with the foundation took on a new level. We are honored, we are thrilled, and we are extremely thankful that we're one of 8 great accelerator programs that received funding under the foundation's KC Accelerator Challenge. So we're very thankful to them for that. And to talk more on that, please welcome their Vice President of Entrepreneurship, Victor Wong.
Thanks, Doug. Just a quick welcome to you all. When we did this KC Accelerator Challenge, we really weren't sure what we were going to get. We knew that there was a lot of really interesting work that was going on in accelerating startup companies, but really weren't quite sure what would happen. We ended up being overwhelmed with responses, and to pick 8 outstanding accelerator ideas that were novel and pioneering and could help accelerate the next wave of startup companies in Kansas City, we found them, and we were thrilled. We're thrilled especially because this Sprint Accelerator has got this opportunity to blend the corporate and the new. And this is something that we found to be a particular strength in this Kansas City area, which is you've wonderful established industries, and then you have new innovations and new startup companies that can leverage and tap into and accelerate the larger strengths that are institutionalized within the city. One of the things we found, too, is that Kansas City is really starting to hit this inflection point in its growth rate for entrepreneurs. 3 years in a row now, the startup index that we run has shown growth in the Kansas City region. We've actually continued to increase our progress over the years, so it's actually a very exciting time in Kansas City. For some background, Kauffman Foundation is in the business of empowering the makers, the doers, and the dreamers, just like the companies here that you'll be seeing later today. And we do this by eliminating the barriers in their way, barriers to mentors, barriers to knowledge, barriers to access to corporate partners, barriers to access to capital. Those types of barriers are what keep people that are making and doing and dreaming stuff from reaching their full potential. We do this in just a few ways. We do it through building the communities that surround them. We do it through giving them better ways to learn from one another. We do it through leveling the playing field. And we also do it through trying to find the big disruptive ideas that are next around the horizon and trying to bring those out into the marketplace. So I'm very thrilled to be able to be here today and introduce and kick off this event for you here today. And I want to congratulate the folks at the Accelerator, Doug, Kevin, and all the rest that have done a tremendous job in bringing this thing to life. Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you, Victor. Since day one, our 90-day accelerator program has obviously been supported by Sprint. But if it wasn't for the work of our next presenter, we probably wouldn't be here today. He went out and got the support from Sprint and others and got us what we needed to get this thing off the ground, and here we are in our fourth year. Now, I have been working for this man for since 100 years, and it has been an amazing journey. Please welcome the CEO of Pinsight Media, Kevin McGinnis.
0-1-1-1-0-0-1-1. Yeah, this isn't in the plan. Doug has already pointed that out to me. So while I appreciate him recognizing me, none of this, and I don't know that there's anywhere in the agenda for this to happen, so I think this is the right place. this program for the last 2 years and the work that he's done prior with us. Doug, I just think that this community owes you a huge thank you for running this program, doing such a fine job. And I appreciate all the hard work you've put into the program, you and the team. And so thank you very much. If you guys can give him a round of applause, please. Good morning. So for us, I'm here representing Pinsight Media, where I am the CEO. We are a wholly owned subsidiary of Sprint Corporation. The journey that Doug has referenced over the last 4 years as it relates to why we have been involved in the entrepreneurial community, why we feel like engagement with entrepreneurs is important, it hasn't really changed, but this program has shifted its focus over those same 4 years. We originally started with mobile healthcare, ran that for 2 years. The third year, we realized that it needed to be something that was more relevant to our business, and I'll talk about that in just a second. So we focused on mobility. We're rather overwhelmed dealing with 10 startups all at the same time, and so this year we decided to, as Doug mentioned, bring in another corporate partner, Dairy Farmers of America, to kind of spread the wealth for the entrepreneurs and really enable us to be more focused and be able to deal with the partnerships. Because that is the focus of this program, is how do we create real partnerships for those companies, and how do we find true value for us, the corporations. So, and by that, the value that we get out of doing these things, if you think about the focus of a large company, it's got a core business model, it needs to focus on top line growth, needs to focus on profitability, really needs to stay focused on its own business. Innovation is extremely difficult in a large corporation. So for us, this is a way to outsource innovation, to outsource new ideas. And what better place to do that than with a group of hungry, ambitious, driven, focused entrepreneurs who are focused on disrupting our businesses in many ways. So this has been a very intentional part of Sprint's innovation strategy and will be going forward. Why we feel like this is important to the growth of the Kansas City community is corporations have to be involved. This isn't just about the entrepreneurs themselves. Many great ideas that start new companies, many of the resources that entrepreneurs need to be successful actually live in these big companies. So for us, trying to lead the way to show a path for other corporations to be involved in this community and to be engaged in entrepreneurship in a meaningful way is extremely important, and we look forward to doing that in the future as well. So a word about the future. If you think about the portfolio of companies that Doug mentioned, not just Pinsight Media and Virgin Mobile, but if you think about Virgin Mobile right now trying to disrupt the prepaid market and the innovation that they're doing, if you think about my company, Pinsight Media, and the work that we're doing to really unlock the value of data in a meaningful way to drive premium insights to businesses and brands, if you think about the very disruptive work that Sprint is trying to do to reshape a customer experience and be a transformative force in the mobile industry through digital transformation, all of that falls under the umbrella of a larger SoftBank portfolio of companies that has a $100 billion venture fund, is focused on things like robotics, artificial intelligence, and Internet of Things. So we not only are anxious to see what this class has done in 2017, but I want to make sure everyone understands that we will be back in 2018, and we will figure out what our focus will be and how we unlock all of the value that those corporations and those focus areas can bring to this community and can bring to entrepreneurs all over the world through the Sprint Accelerator. So with that, thank you very much and enjoy the rest of the program.
Thank you, Kevin. I'm taking the next 3 months off. I don't know if you've heard yet, but we have a new partner, Dairy Farmers of America. And what a partner they have been. The DFA team has been engaged since the first time we met them. They brought in the needed resources, the industry experts. They gave their companies and the companies on the Sprint side access to tools and other assets to make them better businesses. Here to talk about their first year with our program, please welcome their Senior Vice President of Finance, Kevin Strothman.
Morning.
Yeah, there we are. Hey, Doug forgot to mention, I think the most important thing he thought we brought was milk and cheese to the program. I've never seen somebody so excited about that. It's great to be here. Since 2008, innovation has been one of DFA's core values, serving as a compass to our employees as we look to deliver on our mission of bringing value to our 8,000 dairy farm families across the U.S.
Last year, we began to focus more on innovation and how we could connect new ideas and technologies to our farm families and the cooperative. We are proud to have partnered with Sprint Accelerator in sponsoring this year's ag tech portion of the program. The companies that we've worked with are providing thought-provoking, game-changing ideas in the areas of herd management, on-farm assessments, leveraging data to make better decisions, and providing a platform for our growing export business and how we can streamline that. Our goals for the program from the outset were simple. We wanted to learn from the process. We wanted to partner and support thriving startups in the ag tech sector. And we wanted to contribute to Kansas City's growing entrepreneurial spirit. I'm proud to say that we've accomplished all those goals and much more. I'm also excited to announce today that we've already committed to sponsoring next year's portion, ag tech portion of the Sprint Accelerator program. Thank you. In addition to that, we're going to add a second segment that DFA will sponsor, this one focused on dairy food products. We're looking for early stage dairy food companies that are bringing innovative products and packaging to customers in the US and around the world. We're going to support these companies with experts in the areas of research and development, manufacturing, packaging, consumer insights, and marketing. The addition of this second segment to the program means our partnership with Sprint Accelerator now covers all of DFA's businesses and demonstrates our commitment to innovation from farm to table. I'd like to thank all of you for being here, and thanks for supporting the Sprint Accelerator and these great teams you're about to hear from. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Kristen Cody, and I serve as Vice President of Communications for Dairy Farmers of America. In my role, I have the pleasure to work on bringing tools and resources to our dairy farm families that help them make more informed decisions on their operations. Over the last 90 days, I've had the pleasure to work with the My Dairy Dashboard team. This brilliant group of individuals is truly making my dairy data dreams come true. And to learn more about this amazing software that they're bringing to dairy farmers across the US, I would like to introduce CEO of My Dairy Dashboard, Mitch Norby.
Hello, good morning. Thank you. When you get behind the wheel of your car, every piece of information that you need is right there in front of you on your dashboard. With one glance, you can see if you need to add gas to your tank, or if you need an oil change, or if you need to slow down. It's clear visual information to help you make decisions. Dairy farmers today are operating their businesses without a dashboard. It's like driving down the highway at 70 miles per hour and needing to stop every hour and check a spreadsheet to see if you're going to run out of gas. My Dairy Dashboard puts dairy farmers in the driver's seat of their businesses. Our technology breaks down the data silos, automatically connects dairy data, and gives dairy farmers clear visuals of their trends so they can take action on the right things faster. Today, this process of dairy data analysis is painfully manual. Dairy farmers and their veterinarians and their nutritionists often request copies of data from multiple systems on thumb drives and then combine them by hand into spreadsheets. Of course, this process is error-prone, never in real time, and always out of sync, leaving the dairy producer with lagging views of his critical metrics. We have built custom connectors so that the data flows daily from these multiple systems for clear and current views of their most important trends. My Dairy Dashboard is visual, providing dairy farmers and their advisors a better way to see opportunities, as well as being an effective tool for communicating with a workforce for whom English is often a second language. My Dairy Dashboard, beyond visualizing trends, My Dairy Dashboard is a smart platform that can send alerts, such as when feed intake is off or milk fat drops below target. My Dairy Dashboard can also make suggestions as to how a dairy might improve, whether those suggestions are triggered by missing data or trends that don't align with their goals. We're also building a community where dairy farmers can join peer groups with like-minded farmers or form their own peer groups with their neighbors to enable and encourage exchange of ideas and best practices. And the dairy consultants can easily benchmark their herds to save time and add value to their client discussions. We want to go beyond looking in the rearview mirror on what has already happened on the dairy. We want to start to enable farmers to look into the future. We will help them forecast their own milk production, feed requirements, and health events when those are affected by weather forecasts or reproductive results. Just last week, we launched an insiders program for 30 data-minded dairy farmers across the United States so they could start to provide us early feedback in exchange for early access to our technology. The response has been amazing, and we've received great feedback from the applicants, and this is hot off the press. One of the applicants said, "It's pretty awesome to put everything into one place." Another says, "It's such a pain to accomplish this by hand. This is pretty dang cool and exciting." This is pretty dang cool and exciting. We agree. We are also engaged with several dairy consulting companies and co-ops who are eager to work with us to build custom dashboard solutions. We're extremely excited to say that we're working directly with Dairy Farmers of America to enhance their MyDFA member portal by embedding our technology within their site to provide significant additional value to their 8,000 member farms. The MyDairy Dashboard leadership team is stacked with a great mixture of dairy industry expertise, decades of on-farm consulting experience, and a proven track record of 17 years of creating and delivering successful dairy industry software. For the first time, due to MyDairy Dashboard, dairy farmers will have immediate access to their combined data in visual form so they can be introduced to critical insights to take action on the right things faster. MyDairy Dashboard is visual, mobile, connected. If you'd like to hear more about what we're doing, please come find me later. I would love to hear from you. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Wayne Carter, President and CEO of Kansas City Life Sciences. When you're developing a marketing or communication message, how do you know the best words to use, the best images, or the best time to capture the sentiment of your audience? Sentiment, with a C, is an artificial intelligence company. They've developed a contextual sentiment analysis AI platform designed specifically to answer those questions. I'm pleased this morning to introduce to you the CEO and founder of Sentiment, a seasoned, passionate entrepreneur, Micah Brown.
Advertisers are wasting billions every year due to skipped, blocked, and hated ads. They're wasting this money because it's becoming harder and harder to understand who people really are. We project online versions of ourselves that do not correspond with who we are, making it hard to provide advertising that we care about. The approach many advertisers take to this problem is to look at people as data. Ultimately, this doesn't work. Why? Because beneath the data, there are people, real people, who emote and feel and will reject advertising that does not align with their thoughts and feelings. Once you understand someone's thoughts and feelings, you can understand who this person is. You can give them advertising that they can care about and respond to and like. Sentiment does this. Sentiment is thought-driven artificial intelligence, aggregating social media data and using deep learning to understand who people are. Sentiment has built tools such as our emotional search, our deep content search, and text recommendation AI to help brands understand who people are and how they feel. Sentiment currently does this using natural language understanding and machine vision built in partnership with IBM Watson. Very soon, Sentiment will add actual human thought to this process. We're doing this in partnership with KU Med right here in Kansas City. And the reason that we are doing this is to make advertising more ethical and efficient for all people. The Sentiment business model consists of subscription tools across tiers and cost per API calls. But most importantly, Sentiment is doing something amazing. We are combining the worlds of neuroscience and sentiment analysis and programmatic advertising to something that does not currently exist. We are creating the neuro-sentiment market. And we're doing this in partnership with some amazing partners on the commercial and the academic side, including mobile predictive analytics in partnership with Pinsight Media. The Sentiment team consists of neuroscientists and neurophysiologists and psychologists and data scientists and psychographics experts who are all leaders in their field and united in one purpose: making advertising more ethical and efficient and fair for all people. So join me. Sentiment is thought-driven artificial intelligence. Join me in making Sentiment the future of digital marketing. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Brian Smith, and I'm the Chief Revenue Officer of Pinsight Media. And I also have a 5-year-old daughter. And if what you read is true about connected vehicles, I may never have to buy that little girl a car. Yeah, right? One of the companies working to make that content experience better is Dart Technologies. And it is my pleasure to introduce the CEO and founder of Dart Technologies, Michael Chow.
Me in the kitchen like a Simmons whipping pastry, cruising down A Street, off-white Lexus, driving so slow, but BK is from Texas. Me, I'm out that Bed-Stuy, home of that boy.
Good morning. Hello, KAC. I'm here to introduce Dart Discover and how the future of hyperlocal media for connected cars will drive the future of autonomous transport. You're probably familiar with current in-vehicle and in-flight entertainment experiences that leave a lot to be desired on the go. As mobile has shifted screen time from traditional televisions and desktops to pockets in our phone, we see the physical world being augmented through digital experiences anchored by location. With the context of destination, time, weather, passengers can now browse relevant digital samples while in transit. Let's take a look at how this works. The Dart Discover platform is powered by Sprint iPads mounted on the back of headrests in vehicles. Upon entering, passengers choose to enter their destination, personalizing their interactive experience. From there, passengers discover venues nearby the destination, scroll through the snack-sized media reel, check the weather forecast, read today's news, or shop local retailers and on-demand services. The rise of ride shares is disrupting the mobility landscape. In New York City, Uber will surpass yellow taxi trips. This transformation will continue to accelerate, opening up white space for on-demand in-vehicle experiences. To size up the amount of captive time passengers spend in vehicle, a 90-minute commute represents over a month of lost productivity every single year. Futurist storytellers at Pixar depict what personalized TV in transit could potentially look like in the film WALL-E, where screens stream media on demand, optimized for our hyperlocal audiences while achieving reach out of home. Dart Discover is a compelling content distribution platform complete with engagement and attribution analytics, the key to unlocking hyperlocal marketing spend. By tracking media engagement and mobile location data, we measure retail impact based on where demographic audiences flow after drop-off. With Pinsight Media and our programmatic ad exchange, Vistar, We distribute the right content to the right person at the right time, at the right place. Our team has deep experience in digital media over the last dozen years as early members of startups building out fleets of distributed devices. Starting at Kleiner Perkins back to new, now known as RMG Networks, and more recently, working with Starwood Hotels deploying 2,500 Android tablets across 5 resorts in Phoenix, Arizona. Having learned from these past deployments, our mobile tech stack enables business agility through iteratively deploying apps over the air and managing devices remotely. At Dart, we build upon and contribute back to the latest open source technologies, including Facebook's React Native and GraphQL. We're hyper-focused on creating value in the autonomous ecosystem by streaming targeted media over wireless telco infrastructure to subsidize transport fleets. Data is the new oil. And whether you're in media, telco, or transport, there's a highly interconnected role to play in logging the millions of miles necessary to train self-driving cars and becoming safer drivers than humans. If you're part of this ecosystem, we'd love to speak to you afterwards to come along for the ride. Our roadmap starts in the global media capital of the world, New York City, scaling up our fleet to 10,000 vehicles by the end of this year. Looking ahead, what will an autonomous future with connected cars streaming real-time media over 5G gigabit wireless look like for you? There's only one way to find out. Thank you very much.
Good morning. I'm David Darr, president of DFA's Farm Services Division. I'm excited to introduce you to Herd Dog this morning. A big part of my role at DFA is working with our family farm members across the country and trying to find ways that we can help them on their farm to try to make what they do just a little bit easier from one day to the next. And we think Herd Dog can help with that. You know, in any dairy farm operation or livestock operation, a long-term determinant of their success is their ability to breed and raise the next generation of animals on their farm to provide for them and their families and food for all of us. And with Herd Dog, they're taking on tasks like that and jobs like that on the farm and applying technology in a disruptive way that we think that can have value for tens of thousands of farms across the country and millions of animals. So join me in welcoming the founder and CEO of Herd Dog, Melissa Brando, to the stage.
Morning, Kansas City. About 2 years ago, I was with some ranchers, and they had these cattle out in pasture, but they were complaining about the fact that their tags, their radio frequency identification tags, couldn't be read at a distance greater than 3 to 4 inches from the animal's head. Now, in pasture, that's just not gonna work. So I went back and did some research on this problem, thinking somebody must have solved it, only to come to the decision that really nobody had. And I knew that the right technology could, in fact, solve this problem. So I made this problem my passion and started Herd Dog. This is what data collection looks like on a farm typically today. It's kind of clunky. The animals have to be constrained or restrained in order for them to read the data. This is what Herd Dog looks like. Look at those cows. They're completely relaxed, right? Do you think they know that we're collecting data from them? Do you think they even care? I don't think so. Herd Dog combined, we engineered a smart tag, which does in fact collect identification, but also activity as well as body temperature. That tag can be read at a distance of 30 feet using our data gets pushed to the cloud into our individual animal health profiles, and that data is collected over time and interwoven with details from the field like comments, videos, audio files, and so forth. If an alert is generated, that producer will receive a message to their cell phone. So let me give you an example. On dairy farms today, there's about a 30% conception rate, which isn't great. But if you put things in perspective, over a 20-year window, red. So even the best producer is going to have a hard time finding that window. What Herdog does is looks at the data over time, pinpoints the beginning of the cycle, and therefore identifies when that window opens and sends a text message to the producer saying, breed Bessie now. When we came into the program, Dairy Farmers of America, and we think that you can help improve conception rates on dairy farms, we said, we're up for the challenge. And I'm pleased to announce to you today that we're doing a very large-scale dairy pilot in conjunction with Dairy Farmers of America, as well as Colorado State University and Sprint. It starts this week. Really excited about it. Thank you. There's over 94 million cows in the United States today, but the average herd size is only about 40. Technology has been too expensive for a majority of the producers. Herdog blows away the competition because we combine great data with actionable results at a price point that everyone can afford, large or small, beef or dairy. I'm thrilled to have an exceptional team of engineers that I work with, folks that work on mechanical and electrical engineering, firmware and web development. And we've got a great team of advisors with backgrounds in animal husbandry and nutrition and data science. Herdog is truly a game-changing technology for this industry, but this program, in all earnestness, has been a game-changer for Herdog. So thank you.
Hello and good morning. My name is Scott Bamer, and I'm the head of strategic sales at Layer. I've had the privilege of being a mentor since the inception of the Sprint Accelerator program, and we've seen some amazing companies come through this over the time. And as you've seen, this year's class is no exception to that tradition. Today, I'm honored to introduce Oodles Rewards. Oodles is a mobile rewards platform that's focused on driving engagement and insights in some of the key areas and hottest touch points in the industry today, including retail rewards, location, and of course, connected cars. It's my pleasure to introduce the CEO, Zuul Momen.
All I do is win, 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 no matter what. Got money on my mind, I can never get enough. And every time I step...
How many times you have gone into a local store and made a purchase simply because you saw a billboard, TV, or social media ads? Probably never. But why not? Because these ads are ineffective. You know this, and Ford Motor Company knows this, and that's why they chose us to be a part of their connected car program. Today, companies are wasting billions of dollars a year to increase brand awareness. Their goal is to sway you into a local store to buy their products. This process is simply broken. There is no real-time customer engagement, no loyalty, and customer purchase data is lost. And big data has big value. At Oodles, we are reinventing the advertising process itself to help you connect with the great brands that you love. Utilizing powerful connected car technology, we serve drivers with relevant content, promotions, and advertising based on their location and purchasing behavior. Here is a real-life use case of our app. When you are hungry and not sure where to go to eat lunch, our app will find you nearby restaurants with promotions. When you are running low on fuel, our app will display nearby gas stations based on price, brand, promotions, and navigates you there, again saving you both time and money. If you are not driving a connected car, not a problem. You can still use Oodles app to find nearby gas stations, grocery store, restaurants, and much more. Oodles is excited about mobile advertising $37 billion market, which is growing exponentially. In 2016, for the first time, mobile ad spend surpassed half of all digital ad spend and this is estimated to be even bigger in 2017. Oodles is working in this exploding market to monetize data from both connected car and devices. Ford Motor Company chose us, over 170 companies, to be a part of their connected car program. Our app is set to launch in Ford vehicle by end of August 2017. Ford Motor Company has already announced that their technology will be used by mega auto giants like Mazda, Toyota, Suzuki, and Subaru. Being a part of Sprint Accelerator program has enabled us to create a partnership with Sprint and Pinsight Media to access their 60 million plus customers. We have an ongoing partnership with C-Store Pro, a convenience store back office software provider. This relationship will give us an access to create promotion at more than 4,500 plus stores in 39 states and growing upwards of 700,000 by 2020. Our team comprises of entrepreneurs, engineers, designers, and marketers. Our passionate team is on a mission to build a strong AI and data-driven advertising and promotions platform. If you are interested to learn more about our app or can connect us with brand or retailers, please stop by and talk to us. Thank you.
Morning, everyone. My name is Scott Aldridge. I'm Director of Sales for Dairy Farmers of America on our Consumer Products Division. Over the last 3 months, I've had the distinct pleasure of getting to know the team from AgVoice. This team is developing a hands-free, voice-to-data collection technology that's truly changing the way that data is collected on farm. I can tell you that data is important not only on farm, but to the customers that I call on selling our consumer products. The AgVoice team has a tremendous amount of skill and passion and are driven to deliver products specifically for agriculture. At this point, I'd ask you to please help me welcome co-founder of AgVoice, Aaron Gobin.
Jump up, stand by. Night feelings right. Going on a high grade flight. Dogs are roll out, girls are roll out. Everything is nice.
KC, it's great to be here with you. I tell you what, out here, a lot of beautiful people, this auditorium, it's fantastic. This is 21st century stuff, right? Well, I'll tell you, I was really excited to get out here, and I got to catch my breath because of that little run. But I was raring to go because although here is really modern, the green room is not too green. It reminds me of a World War I bunker, so I was raring to go. So Scott did a great job. Thanks, Scott, for the intro. He missed one thing, which is I have a very dry, sarcastic sense of humor. So there might be at different phases throughout the presentation where you're not sure if it's a joke or not. So the solution to that is, if you're not sure, don't think twice, just laugh. Yeah, that's fine, just laugh. AgVoice is building the world's first voice interactive system for agriculture professionals that capture data on the go. The food that we eat every day, here's what it looks like. But how can we better communicate that it was grown in a safe and environmentally responsible way? Let's take the example of our partner, DFA. Their customers like Walmart, McDonald's, Unilever, and Nestle all request information directly from the farm. They do this to ensure that the milk quality and the animal care meet the expectations of consumers like you and me. Here's the problem. At the grassroots of the food supply chain, the tools being used to capture information is not as accurate, not as efficient, not as hands-free as it should be. This inspector, every single day, needs to take her iPad out in the field with her. She has a paper clipboard. She's wearing gloves, when all she really needs are her two hands free
to inspect plants so that you could understand how important inspections are for the industry. In one part of California alone, the Salinas Valley, over $9 billion worth of fruits and vegetables need to be inspected every single year. Imagine if you had to check on 6,000 dairy cows in a single day. Well, there is an inspector that does this. After completing artificial intelligence, yes, it is a two-handed process, and I've been asked this before, no, I'm not doing the lightning bolt celebration that Usain Bolt does at the end of a 100-meter race. I'll do that at the end of the presentation. After completing artificial insemination, the inspector needs to take notes. Sometimes he does it on the back of his hand with a Sharpie. He does this for one reason, to remember key information for when he gets back to his office at the end of the day. These situations combined cost the industry billions every year in lost productivity, and it also highlights some of the existing bottlenecks and issues for end-to-end traceability. AgVoice is the solution. We're providing data integrity to our customers at that moment of origin, the moment of truth. This inspector reads the cow ID off the air tag. He says 1380, body condition looks good, rating 3. AgVoice reads back into his earpiece, body condition 3. The inspector is then able to enter any value into the system. He's also able to update or change any value, in this case, changing hygiene from 1 to 2. After he completes his checklist, the inspector can then carry on with his day. Our first of its kind technology works on any smartphone anywhere on the planet. We integrate into existing corporate workflow management systems. The reports that we send to our customers are geolocated with the date and the timestamp included to ensure a protected order chain. We've purpose-built AgVoice to work offline because there are many farms around the world that still do not have a good enough cell or data connection. We're targeting large commercial operations first within the categories of animal health, fruits, and vegetables. In the second half of this year, we will expand into row crops as well as machinery repair. In 2018, the company will progress into quality control as well as trucking fleet and cargo inspections. We're focused on enterprise partnerships via licensing agreements. And to expand into this $8 billion market, we're building our developers' API. This is where existing software and solution providers in the industry could extend the benefits of the AgVoice voice-to-data service to their existing customer base. We're focused on 6 partner wins this year. And of those 6, we are already working with these 3 major companies that produce all that delicious food we enjoy. We have a world-class team with deep experience in both agriculture as well as technology. Actually, I just want to clarify something. Looking at the images, I'm actually the best-looking member of the AgVoice team, but the image doesn't reflect that, so I need to update that after. So as an example of the deep experience and expertise, our chief speech officer led the research and development into the Amazon Alexa. I wanted to take the opportunity today to share a little piece of momentum that our team was really pumped up about last week. In New York City, we were given the Judge's Choice Award for being the most disruptive agriculture technology in that competition as voted by Rabobank. Thank you. I love being here in KC. A couple days ago, someone asked me, how am I enjoying the program? I told them, you know, between the fantastic mentors we've had and all the collisions and collaboration I've had with my fellow entrepreneurs, who you've seen many of them on stage already, spending 3 months in this city being part of the DFA and Sprint program has made KC is really one of my top 3 favorite cities in the entire country now. And I do plan to spend a lot more time here moving forward. But today, we're here to meet with the most innovative food companies on the planet. At the reception, I look forward to meeting you and understanding how AgVoice could help. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Ona Coker, and I am the Assistant Director for Export Fulfillment for Dairy Farmers of America. So over the past couple of months, we've been working with Trade Lanes, and we've been given the unique opportunities to see how they can show us the possibilities for smart trade when it comes to export processes. It's been a very exciting couple of months because we've been able to see them talk about continuously and unveil new functionalities that leverages automation. And it's given us unique insight to see how, as a company, you can begin to basically redirect your human resource capital to focus more on value-added work, because that's the bottom line. With that in mind, I would like you to welcome the CEO of TradeLinks, Vijay Irel.
I gotta testify, come up in the spot looking extra fly for the day I die.
Good morning. Trade Lanes eliminates the manual paperwork needed to ship ocean containers. According to the World Trade Organization, this manual paperwork costs the global trade industry $1 trillion every year. This is important because 90% of everything around you travels by ocean container at least once in its lifetime. This is the backbone of global trade. Your jeans, your shirt, baby formula, yogurt, Borden's cheese, products that feed and clothe the world. Shipping that ocean container requires a dozen documents handed off through 15 different people. The challenge is that these paper documents are manually generated. At each handoff, more documents are created. Now, these documents dictate who owns the container, if the goods can pass through customs, and when payment can be collected. The problem is that the error rates on these documents is a whopping 75%. This leads to unnecessarily high export costs, delays in shipping, and delays in payment. Trade Lanes has created a digital document room that automatically generates these documents. From beginning to end, at each handoff, our rooms collect all supply chain data, creating a single source of truth for every shipment. This eliminates document error rates, removes 10 days from the supply chain, and saves exporters up to 80% on trade management. And more importantly, by using our platform, exporters can get paid up to 30 days faster. And who doesn't like to get paid faster? Our simple yet beautiful interface is event-driven, converting a complex process into a series of mouse clicks. Starting at the transaction between the buyer and the seller, to booking freight and automatically generating your global trade documents, there's real-time tracking and alerts for major shipment events. All of this happens in our collaborative trade rooms that enable error-free, seamless handoffs of all global trade documents. The pace of innovation and global trade is gaining momentum. In the last several years, we've seen major players implement advanced digital strategies. Now, it's important to note that 80% of the data needed to export comes from external supply chain partners. Our competitor software shackles exporters to the data they already have, only solving 20% of the problem. Trade Lanes frees exporters from these shackles, pulling in all supply chain data into a single source of truth, solving 100% of the problem. This is a huge market, huge. We focus on US exporters at the moment, but there's a lot of opportunity to expand our business on a global scale. Having just released the enterprise version of our platform 90 days ago, we're already working with the largest brands in agriculture. Our leadership team has started and built multiple ventures with exits totaling over $10 billion. And today, we're proud to announce the newest member of our leadership team as a local hire from right here in Kansas City.
KC, baby!
Delvin, where you at? Trade Lanes is the only unified platform for smart trade. We're building the future. Thank you.
Thank you, VJ. At this time, I'd like all of the companies and all of their employees that are here in the audience to please come on stage. If you've had a direct connection to our program through mentoring, through our business development sessions, please join us on stage at this time. We'd like to take a big group picture. While they're doing that, I also want to thank the other sponsors of our program, Amazon Web Services, American Airlines, our great friends at Hush Blackwell. Where are you guys? Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Silicon Valley Bank. And for helping us get through some of the longer days in the program, our good friends at Stockyards Brewing Company. You should definitely check them out. They're delicious. Thank you guys for being here. Your support of our program means the world to not only me, but everyone else associated. And we look forward to seeing you at Demo Day 2018. Thank you. Dennis, did you have an announcement?
Please join us in the lobby for an opportunity to meet with our companies.